Hello friends, welcome to my channel. My name is Wolo. I want to say thank you to everyone who have subscribed to my channel. It is actually 23rd of December and it is 2 days to Christmas. And anybody who has subscribed to this channel from the beginning of this year till now and has seen all of my videos, I want to say thank you. I appreciate you so much. I am very grateful for you and, you know, sharing my videos and all that. Thank you so much. The channel is about sharing information about life in Canada, immigrating to Canada, and everything in between concerning Canada. And today I actually want to make a request to every one of my subscribers. I know we're all struggling to kind of, you know, do a lot of things, and we all have our own needs and wants and all that, but it's a season of giving. And I will make this special request that you look around you and put a smile on somebody's face. You might have an extra change that you don't need. You might have some clothes that you're not using. You might have some food that is extra in your house. If you have all these things extra, you should be grateful. I am grateful for all that I have. And I'm also grateful for everybody that have subscribed. And I am making this special request that you should actually spread this season of love by giving to people around you. Look for somebody who is in need and bless the person, and the universe will smile back at you. There is a law concerning giving. I don't know, I just feel that people who give always get more back, and that is why this channel is growing, because I give free content and have responded to over 5,000 emails, and I have been able to actually save some people from losing monies to fraudulent agencies, fraudulent people promising people work permit and stuff like that. I've been able to kind of save them from losing their money. So if I have been able to do that and give you free information and content, I expect that you do the same to somebody who needs some form of help or the other. So I hope my intro is not too long. Thank you for subscribing and everything. Today's video is about poverty in Canada, and poverty is everywhere in the world. There is no two ways about it. No matter how rich a country is, there will always be poor people in that country. Canada has good quality of life. Yes, that is true, but there are people who are living below a minimum threshold of income for a family. And in 2015, the poverty rate of Canada was 12% according to Statistics Canada. And then in 2017, the poverty rate is currently sitting at 9.5% as at 2017. We don't know the figures for 2019 yet, but the plan is to reduce the poverty by 2030 to 6% in Canada, which means the government of Canada is actually doing a good job in trying to eradicate poverty from the country and trying to make people live above the poverty level. And there are various causes of poverty. Number one major cause is the low income rate. Now, the minimum wage is different across provinces, and based on that, when one family member is working and is being paid minimum wage, it's very difficult for that person to actually pay his or her bills, actually eat, and, you know, have one or two little change in his or her pocket for emergencies. And based on that, it's very easy to slip into poverty. It's very easy to slip into homelessness. And the good thing is the government of Canada and some independent organizations have actually put in some infrastructures in place to mitigate against this kind of poverty. So for people who do not really have anything and are falling into the poverty line, they have some, you know, kind of buffer. They have a welfare system in place that can provide shelter for them, and they also have a welfare system in place that can provide food. There are various food banks everywhere in Canada. In every province you find a food bank. So if somebody does not have food in his or her house, the person can go to a food bank and collect food for his family. They also have shelter for the homeless. So if somebody is homeless, the person has, you know, could not pay his rent or could not pay his bills and was kicked out of his home, there are shelters that are available in every province where the person can go sleep and then shower, and the next day the person can be out doing one or two things and, you know, the person's dignity is still maintained as an individual. So based on this, the government of Canada is actually putting in enough efforts, and they have established a poverty reduction strategy to see how they can try to put monies in people's pockets. Yeah, people will always work minimum wage job, yes, but there are other benefits in place that the government has put to help families live above the poverty line. In Winnipeg, a family of four, a father, mother, and two children, if the family net income after taxes is $36,544, that means that family is on the poverty line. But the government of Manitoba has things like the rent assistance that can help that family pay their rent. There are food banks, like I mentioned before, and yeah, so all these things are in place, and there are also places where people can go get free clothing and, you know, any other thing that they need just to survive on a daily basis until their income level goes above that net income. So this is what the government of Canada is doing, and to ensure that people are not on the poverty line, and they are providing welfare assistance for a lot of people who are on the poverty line and trying to provide shelter for the homeless and all that. So that's why I am grateful for being in Canada. And yeah, even though we are paying so much taxes, yeah, but then it's actually going to improve certain services for people to ensure that people are not living on the poverty line. So this is the information I want to share for you today, and yeah, try to make someone smile. I know it's not easy, we all want one or two things, but try as much as possible to make someone smile this Christmas, and see you in my next video. Bye bye.